Could you tell us about the letter that yesterday you drafted and many members of Congress signed on to?
Well, yesterday we were, after drafting and getting a huge support among fellow members, almost the total leadership of the Republican Party, Democrats and Republicans sending a letter to President Obama saying now is the time to move on the Panama Free Trade Agreement. This is a critical component, not just for Panama, but for the American worker. This is one place Democrats and Republicans can work together. We're talking about Panama now is committed to a major expansion that they've already started of the Panama Canal with lots of construction and a lot of opportunity for purchase of American equipment, especially heavy equipment in industries like Caterpillar, John Deere and the different Cummins operations. They would like to buy and be able to trade with America on these issues rather than China. Now's the time for the administration to move on this, to bring this bill forward and allow it to get passed so that our manufacturers, so our business people, so our workers can actually profit with this relationship with the expansion of the new canal rather than having other countries in the Far East or Europe benefit. So I think the challenge here is moving quickly, not finding excuses to delay. Even the human rights and the labor unions understand that Panama is an example of the kind of free trade we need. It's fair and free, and to delay it, to stall it, will cost American taxpayers and cost American workers their jobs.
Is this a bipartisan effort?
This is absolutely a bipartisan effort. What's a great part about this is you don't have to choose Republican or Democrat on this thing. This is across the board. It's a lot of good support from both sides because the fact is we all see that this is about American workers. Not Republicans, not Democrats, but Americans, and especially those who desperately need the jobs now, need the stimulus in the industries that would be benefited from this agreement. So now the president needs to be politically brave enough to do the right thing, bring this bill before us and allow us to prove it, and then move forward with the economic opportunities it provides.
Have you gotten any reaction from the White House on this bill?
We haven't received any feedback yet from the White House, but we just sent it. So hopefully we'll hear from them soon. We'll hear from them with a positive attitude, and I think this is one place where members of Congress and the administration can show the American people that we put American workers first and politics second.